harnessing the strength and ferocity of the swift wildcat. This monstrous villainess has been a menace to the legendary Amazon superhero, Wonder Woman. All who have worn the dreadful, spotted pelt are known for their savage terror. Prepare for the tale of the fatal feline, the cheetah. The cheetah made her first appearance in the Golden Age of comics. During a fundraiser, Wonder Woman performed feats of strength and escape artistry in front of a captive audience. The fundraiser was promoted by the wealthy socialite Priscilla Rich. Rich, while herself beautiful and wealthy, held a deep resentment and jealousy toward Wonder Woman. While Wonder Woman prepared for an elaborate underwater escape act, Rich attempted to sabotage the performance by binding Wonder Woman's hands with her own unbreakable magic lasso without the hero noticing. She hoped the hero would drown while in her binding. Next, Rich watched with anticipation as the Amazon was submerged in a giant water tank. Though a resourceful Wonder Woman managed to unravel the binding of the lasso, free from the tank, the audience cheered her amazing escape. Though disappointed, Rich pretended to be happy to see Wonder Woman survive the ordeal. After the performance, Rich went with her colleague, Courtly Darling, to store the thousands of dollars they raised from the show. Wonder Woman showed up to invite Darling and Rich to an evening party arranged in her honor. While Darling jumped at the opportunity, Rich was disappointed as Darling now disregarded the plans he made with her to go out with Wonder Woman instead. Frustrated, Rich rejected Wonder Woman's invitation and went home. Now furious that Wonder Woman had foiled her plot to drown her, and went on to sideline her evening plans, Rich ruminated over her hatred for the hero. When she sat down before her vanity mirror, she saw a horrifying reflection of herself. Rich's anger manifested as a powerful, vengeful spirit that called herself the Cheetah. The cheetah commanded Rich to take one of her cheetah skin rugs and clothe herself in it. Now dressed as the swift African predator, the cheetah spirit commanded her to exact vengeance on Wonder Woman. That night, as the cheetah, she broke into Courtly Darling's office and stole the money from the fundraiser. The cheetah next stalked Darling and Wonder Woman in the shadows and overheard Wonder Woman claim to be staying with her friend Diana Prince, who was secretly Wonder Woman's alter ego. The cheetah later went to Prince's home and found Wonder Woman asleep. While tempted to kill her in bed, she decided that she would rather torment her by making the hero into a public disgrace. The cheetah then hid the stolen money under the bed and left. The next morning, Rich called Darling with concerns about the security of the money. Darling agreed to retrieve the money from his office and meet Rich at the bank. Darling could not find the money and reported it stolen. Rich insisted that Wonder Woman must be to blame as she was the only other person who knew where the money was, and revealed the hero lived with Diana Prince. The police were called to search Prince's home and the money was discovered. Rich insisted that Wonder Woman and Darling must have stolen the money together and set up Prince to take the fall. In all the commotion, Prince slipped away and changed into Wonder Woman and took off to investigate. She later found Darling being held hostage by the cheetah. Holding them at gunpoint, the cheetah was able to force Wonder Woman and Darling into a grain silo, leaving them for dead. Though Wonder Woman would escape with Darling, the cheetah attempted to set fire to the building but lost control of the flame and fell into the blaze, believed to have died. The cheetah survived the ordeal and would appear again when she attempted to infiltrate the mysterious island paradise home of the Amazons. Wonder Woman held a competition to determine if the world's most accomplished female athletes could compete with Amazons. Priscilla Rich kidnapped and impersonated one of the American athletes and traveled to the Amazon island with the hope of discovering the source of the Amazon's incredible powers. She learned from Wonder Woman that her magic lasso was forged from the same material as the Amazon Queen's golden girdle. Later that night, as the cheetah, she sneaked past the Amazon Queen's guards and stole the girdle for herself. The cheetah then found the queen and kidnapped her, holding her hostage. When the queen awoke, the cheetah proclaimed that she plotted to overthrow Paradise Island and rule the Amazons herself. Wonder Woman and her allies followed clues that led them to the cheetah, who they found intended to kill the queen by crushing her with a boulder. Wonder Woman challenged the cheetah to a duel to settle their rivalry. The cheetah descended to face the Amazon warrior in combat. The Cheetah then admitted that she hated and envied Wonder Woman and was glad to have the chance to battle her. In their battle, Wonder Woman's strength was matched by the Cheetah, who was empowered by the Golden Girdle. Wonder Woman was victorious. Though not willing to be outdone, the Cheetah went to complete her plot by pushing the boulder toward the Amazon Queen. Wonder Woman saved the Queen from the boulder while her allies caught the Cheetah, exposing her identity as Priscilla Rich. The Cheetah would return as a constant menace to Wonder Woman. She would join forces with several of the Amazon heroes' other female foes in the criminal group known as Villainy Incorporated. The Cheetah maintained her grudge against Wonder Woman for many years, fighting her and maintaining her jealous feud with the Amazon hero. Through all of this, the Cheetah struggled with her dual personas constantly at war within her. Some years later, Wonder Woman faced a new breed of the Cheetah. One day, while putting out a fire from a damaged oil tanker at sea, Wonder Woman received help from an environmentalist group led by a charming woman named Deborah Domaine. After securing the oil tanker, Wonder Woman thanked Domaine for her help and departed. Later, Domaine received a message informing her that one of her close relatives was terminally ill and wanted to see Domaine quickly. Domaine was on her way. Arriving at a mansion, she entered, though she did not realize she was being watched. Making her way to the master bedroom, Domaine found her aunt, Priscilla Rich, bedridden. Rich was sickly and in hysterics when she saw Domaine. Rich was upset her niece decided to visit her on this day. She admitted that she wanted to confess her past to her niece, but now it was too late. Rich then urged her niece to run and escape while she still could. In that last hysterical panic, Priscilla Rich appeared to have died. Shocked, Domaine leapt backward, falling toward a closet and struck her head. Out of the closet, a mannequin dressed in Rich's old cheetah costume fell out. The strike to the head caused her to black out. Before passing out, Domaine saw a strangely dressed man enter the room, approaching her. Domaine later woke up suspended in a strange apparatus. Domaine was held captive by the villainous cult of Cobra. They wanted to make her one of their agents. She was met by a shadowy figure who claimed to have planned to forcibly recruit Rich as an agent, but now that she appeared to be dead, he was willing to make use of her niece. Next, Domaine was bombarded with holographic images of environmental violence and destruction, coupled with electroshock stimulation. This was all meant to overwhelm her senses, break her psyche and brainwash her. Once the process was complete, she was fully transformed into the new Cheetah. Domaine, now as the Cheetah, was sent on a mission to shut down a hydroelectric dam. The mass flooding that followed caught the attention of Wonder Woman. Soon the hero recognized Domaine and was shocked to see that she was now dressed as the Cheetah, and even more shocked to see an environmentalist such as herself had caused such a disaster. Now locked in battle, the Cheetah now claimed a new cause to save the Earth by destroying humanity. The Cheetah was able to overpower Wonder Woman and escape. Wonder Woman would follow Domaine to her yacht with the hope of discovering how the woman became a violent criminal in just one day. Suddenly, the Cheetah pounced on Wonder Woman and they were trapped in a battle again. In their fight, the Cheetah admitted that she intended to commit more crimes of mass destruction with the hope of destroying humanity. Realizing the villain was brainwashed, Wonder Woman attempted to reason with her. Suddenly, the yacht crashed into a ferry. Wonder Woman survived, but she could not find the Cheetah and feared the worst for her. The Cheetah would survive this incident, and soon she would encounter the secret society of supervillains. The criminal group recruited her in their plan to attack the superhero teams, the Justice League and the Justice Society. The Cheetah was given the task of facing off with Wonder Woman again. The Cheetah stalked Wonder Woman to Washington, D.C. and was able to overpower the hero. The Secret Society's plan was to rid the world of its greatest heroes. Their plot fell apart when several members of the Secret Society were betrayed from within. The betrayed villains sought revenge and decided to free the captured superheroes. The Cheetah was instrumental in this effort when she freed Wonder Woman. The Secret Society was then quickly defeated by the combined forces of the Justice League and the Justice Society. When DC Comics went through a massive editorial overhaul after the crossover event known as the Crisis on Infinite Earths, the Cheetah was completely revamped and reintroduced. Dr. Barbara Minerva was a British archaeologist and heir to a vast family fortune. Minerva was fixated on the legend of a secret tribe in the jungles of Africa that worshipped a powerful cat god. Going in search of this tribe, Minerva and her colleagues faced attacking tribes people and traveled across treacherous terrain. They finally found the mysterious tribe in the midst of a firelit ceremony. Minerva witnessed the tribe perform a human blood sacrifice. A shaman collected the blood to prepare as a mystic brew. Then, a withered, old woman dressed in a cheetah skin robe was presented on an altar. As the shaman handed the brew to the old woman to drink, a bullet flew through the air, shattering the brew's goblet and struck the old woman. The whole tribe was overtaken by an assault of gun-wielding invaders, killing everyone in sight. The shaman attempted to protect the old woman and gained some surprise help from Minerva when she jumped in to rescue them. The shaman explained that he had nothing left to live for, as he had failed the cat god, and that he wanted Minerva to kill him. Minerva demanded an explanation for the ritual she witnessed. The shaman, named Chuma, explained that the tribe worshipped a powerful plant spirit they called Urzkartaga. The plant required blood sacrifices in order to empower the tribe's powerful guardian cat god. Due to improper worship practices in the past, the cat god was losing her power and now near death. The current invasion of the enemy countrymen, who had been historically terrorized by the tribe, disrupted the attempt to revive the cat god, and now she would certainly die. Intrigued by the story, Minerva demanded Shuma to put her through the ritual to become the new cat god. The shaman prepared her for the process and mixed the sacred bloody brew for her to drink. Moments later, she was transformed into the terrifying cat god. Armed with incredible speed, enhanced strength and agility, wielding razor-sharp claws and teeth, and driven by a powerful bloodlust, she was now the cheetah. She then attacked the invading countrymen in a bloodthirsty rage, killing them all. Minerva now harnessed incredible power, but there was one terrible flaw. The plant spirit required the cat god to be a virgin. As Minerva was not chaste, this created a terrible side effect. The plant over time made her weak and physically disabled. The only time she was strong was when she was the cheetah. Now she had to frequently hunt for new blood sacrifices to perform new rituals to maintain her strength as the cheetah. Soon Minerva became aware of Wonder Woman and her powerful golden lasso of truth. Determined to add the weapon to her archaeological collection, she concocted a lie. Minerva contacted Wonder Woman, claiming to have in her possession an ancient Amazonian artifact, made from the same material as the lasso, which she wanted to share with the hero. Excited, Wonder Woman agreed to meet with Minerva. In their meeting, Wonder Woman allowed Minerva to hold the lasso, but its mystical power compelled her to confess that she lied in order to obtain the lasso. Heartbroken by the betrayal, Wonder Woman stormed out of the meeting. Later that same night, Minerva performed her ritual and transformed into the cheetah. She then took off to stalk Wonder Woman with the hope of taking the lasso by force. Finding the hero visiting a friend's home, the cheetah attacked, igniting a terrible fight between the two women. Just as it seemed the cheetah would win this battle, Wonder Woman's friend appeared with a gun and opened fire at the cheetah. The villain fell into a nearby lake and escaped. After this, the cheetah would be a constant menace to Wonder Woman. The feline terror's obsession with the magic lasso would be replaced by a need to destroy the Amazon hero out of a personal vendetta. Sometime later, a new cheetah appeared to attack Wonder Woman. This new cheetah, though, was a man. This new male cheetah joined forces with other villains to terrorize Wonder Woman. For some time, the new cheetah was a total mystery, and Wonder Woman was tremendously confused about what might have happened to Minerva. Meanwhile, Wonder Woman learned that one of her close allies, who derived powers from the legendary Furies, was suffering from a total power loss. A fellow Amazon did an investigation to discover why this might have happened. The Amazon discovered that a mystical artifact connected to the Furies had been stolen by a thief for hire. The thief went on to deliver the artifact to his employer, Dr. Barbara Minerva. As it turned out, the new cheetah was a wealthy Argentinian businessman named Sebastian Ballesteros. Overcome with a superiority complex, Ballesteros was always looking for new sources of power. He heard about Urzkartaga and the cheetah cat god, and was determined to have its power for himself. He sought out Minerva to obtain the wicked plant and made a case to Erskartago that he would be better suited as a host for the cat god because Ballesteros was a man, and felt he could better handle the power Erskartago offered. The plant spirit was convinced and tossed Minerva aside, and bound itself to Ballesteros. Bitter and vengeful, Minerva was determined to reclaim the cat god power that she felt was rightfully hers. That is when Minerva employed a thief to steal the artifact that granted her the power of the Furies. Now with new energy, Minerva took off on her vengeful mission to reclaim the power of the cheetah. Minerva traveled to Buenos Aires, Argentina, and confronted Ballesteros. This led to a horrible battle in the streets that caught the attention of Wonder Woman. The hero realized both Minerva and Ballesteros were misusing the powers of gods for petty vengeance. She preferred to give these monsters space to fight each other freely and away from innocent bystanders. Their battle nearly destroyed both of them, causing them to lose all of their powers, as evidenced when the power of the Furies abandoned Minerva and returned to their original holder. Minerva survived the battle, recovering to reunite with Erskartago. Using a new blood sacrifice from Ballesteros, her cat god powers returned to her. She was ready to strike back at her rival, Wonder Woman. This time she joined forces with the villainous Reverse Flash, better known as Zoom, archfoe of the super speed hero known as the Flash. The cheetah wanted Zoom to help her further cultivate her super speed power. Zoom agreed, as he had an obsession with helping people become better versions of themselves. Zoom advised the cheetah that she needed to secure her mantle as the cheetah. Priscilla Rich, the original cheetah, turned out to still be alive, now an old woman aged in her 80s. Rich had apparently always openly expressed resentment of Minerva acting as the cheetah. Zoom insisted that Minerva should kill Rich to fortify herself as the current cheetah. Meanwhile, both Wonder Woman and the Flash became aware of the partnership of their mutual foes and teamed up to confront them. The heroes tracked down the villains to Rich's home, but it was too late. They found the home ransacked and the elderly Priscilla Rich dead. Next, Zoom and the cheetah appeared and attacked the heroes, leading to a terrible battle. The villains exchanged foes as the cheetah wanted to show off her new speed powers to the Flash. Though they put up a good fight, Zoom and the cheetah were overpowered by the heroes. Soon after, the two villains were abducted, as their team up was part of an initiation into the new secret society of supervillains. The cheetah would go on to be a constant menace to Wonder Woman. After receiving a power boost from a powerful witch, the cheetah would gain the ability to transform from human to cat form without need for the blood ritual. Her human disability also appeared to have healed as well. She would go on to use her professional connections to sabotage Wonder Woman secretly, as well as confront her head on in combat. Next, DC Comics would go through another major editorial restructuring that introduced a new era known as the New 52. Here many characters and concepts were rebooted, including the cheetah. Barbara Minerva once again was an archaeologist. This time she was one of the first people that Wonder Woman met when she arrived in the modern world, and became friends with her. When Minerva was cataloging a mystical dagger, known as the Godslayer, she cut herself accidentally. The Godslayer housed the spirit of the cat god and transformed Minerva into the cheetah, which led her on a violent killing spree. As it turned out, Minerva grew up in an isolated female-dominated cult that worshipped the Greek goddess of the hunt. Minerva was trained to be a ruthless hunter from childhood and was sent on a mission by her cult to obtain the Godslayer dagger to use in one of their cult rituals. She would intentionally stab herself in the heart with the dagger to obtain the power of the cheetah. Wonder Woman was determined to save her so-called friend Minerva and return her to normal. The hero would enlist her colleagues in the Justice League to help her. The team's investigation led them to the jungles of the African Congo. In the jungle, they were attacked by the cheetah. Her ferocity overwhelmed the heroes. The cheetah attacked Superman, biting him in the neck, which transformed him into a hybrid cheetah monster. As the battle intensified, suddenly local tribal natives presented themselves. The tribal leader used a sound weapon to overpower the cheetah and Superman. While the cheetah ran off, Superman was contained while the tribe's people cured him of the cheetah monster. Batman then demanded an explanation for the cheetah's behavior. The tribal leader explained that the cat god's spirit was actually the guardian of their tribe. Long ago, a trophy hunter came to the jungle wielding the mystical godslayer dagger, which was designed to kill gods and deities. The hunter attacked the then host of the cat god, killing her, and absorbed the cat spirit into the dagger, sealing it within. The godslayer would eventually find its way into Minerva's possession when she discovered that it carried the spirit of the cat god. Now in the jungle, Wonder Woman engaged in combat with the cheetah, and with the help of Aquaman was able to overpower and capture her. As it turned out, Minerva was also a con artist and career criminal with a checkered past, using a long list of aliases. Once imprisoned, the cheetah confessed that the cat god was not an evil spirit at all. Rather, it was Minerva herself who was the negative personality, and she used the cat god as a source of power. The cheetah would soon after be locked away in a prison dedicated to super criminals. When the Justice League mysteriously disappeared, the evil super team known as the Crime Syndicate came to Earth, liberated while imprisoned supervillains, and enlisted them in their army, with the intention of taking over the world. The now freed cheetah gained possession of Wonder Woman's magic lasso of truth, and took off into hiding in New York City's Central Park. This led to a confrontation with Wonder Woman's close ally, Steve Trevor. Trevor was trying to recover the Justice League and realized that the lasso may be the key to doing so. Trevor found himself locked in a vicious battle with the cheetah, where he was bound in the lasso by the villain. The cheetah amused herself by using the lasso to get Trevor to confess his loving feelings for Wonder Woman. Frustrated and somewhat embarrassed, he realized that an honest and pure person could effectively control the lasso. He was then able to wrest control of the lasso from the cheetah, overpowering her. After the Justice League returned and the Crime Syndicate was defeated, many among the villain army, including the cheetah, were taken back into custody. While in prison, she was recruited into the convict black ops government operatives known as the Suicide Squad. Here, her ferocious power proved highly valuable on many of the team's missions. In yet another company-wide reboot at DC Comics, the Rebirth event reintroduced many concepts and characters. The cheetah was again reworked and reintroduced. Here, Barbara Cavendish was the daughter of a wealthy British family. From childhood, she took an avid interest in classical mythology. Her father saw her interest as a waste and discouraged her. Defiant of her father, she diligently studied mythology and foreign cultures anyway, even changing her surname to her mother's maiden name, Minerva. She would become multilingual and earn 2 PhDs in archaeology. As a renowned career archaeologist, Minerva found evidence of the Amazon civilization. She would continue her research with the hope of eventually encountering their civilization. When Wonder Woman first arrived in the United States, the hero encountered the US military. Minerva was called in as a translator for Wonder Woman, who at the time did not speak English. Here, Minerva became a close friend to the hero during her transition in the modern world. Minerva witnessed Wonder Woman's first battles as she bravely fought terrorists and the war god Ares himself. Seeing all of this, Minerva was obsessed with finding more proof of living gods and deities. Minerva discovered legends of the African jungle plant god, Inescapable. She sought out sponsorship from a wealthy industrialist, Veronica Gale, who offered to fully support Minerva's entire research expedition in Africa. In truth, Gale was being controlled by agents of the god Ares, who sought to destroy the Amazons. Minerva had been set up to be forced into a ritual where Inescapable transformed her into a bloodthirsty cheetah monster. Wonder Woman would discover her friend's terrible transformation and blamed herself for not being there to rescue her friend from such powerful forces. Wonder Woman took up the task of freeing Minerva from Inescapable and returning her to normal. Wonder Woman was able to find the cheetah and fight the zealot worshippers of Inescapable and prevent another ritual that would grant the evil plant god even more power. With her magic lasso of truth, Wonder Woman was able to destroy Inescapable, allowing Minerva to regain her humanity. The Inescapable plant regenerated into a young bud, and would come into the possession of Kale. Kale would contact Minerva again and explained that she needed the cheetah's incredible power for her own means. Kale threatened to have Minerva's friends murdered if she did not agree to become the cheetah again. Minerva reluctantly agreed to be transformed into the cheetah. Once again, Wonder Woman would continue to do battle with the fatal feline on numerous occasions. The cheetah would also move on to join forces with the notorious supervillain, Lex Luthor, as a member of the Legion of Doom and do battle with the Justice League, fighting the Amazon hero Wonder Woman. The cheetah has made several appearances in other media. In the 1978 animated series, Challenge of the Super Friends, the Priscilla Rich version of the cheetah appears. Here the villain is a member of the Legion of Doom, and maintains a grudge against Wonder Woman. Her most memorable appearance in the series is when she travels back in time to the Amazon's island paradise to compete in the famed tournament that allowed the Amazon princess, Diana, to become Wonder Woman. Rich disguises herself as an Amazon contender progressing through the tournament to face Diana in the final round. Using trickery, she is able to overpower Diana and win the contest, appearing to eliminate Wonder Woman from history. The 2001 Justice League animated series makes use of the Barbara Minerva version of the cheetah. Here she is a biogeneticist doing scientific research into animal genes. Though she became desperate when she could not acquire funding for her projects, she was forced to use herself as a test subject. Now transformed into a cheetah hybrid creature, she was shunned by the scientific community for her recklessness, and rejected by society as a freak. She became a career criminal with the hopes of supporting herself. This led her to join the Injustice Gang, where she would do battle with Wonder Woman and the Justice League. Other versions of the cheetah appear in various DC cartoon shorts, animated features, as well as DC Universe video games. In the 2020 motion picture, Wonder Woman 1984, the Barbara Minerva version of the cheetah is featured. Actress Kristen Wiig portrays the character. Here she is an archaeologist who befriends Diana Prince before gaining the powers of the cheetah. What do you think? Which cheetah is your favorite? Is the cheetah a worthy opponent of Wonder Woman? Is it peculiar that an animal native to grasslands and open plains has been associated with tropical jungles? Leave your thoughts in the comment section below. Hope you enjoyed this video. Please feel free to share it, and please subscribe to this channel. Click the bell icon to be immediately notified of new releases. Please support the content on this channel by visiting the donation page through the link in the description box below. Also, please visit the affiliate links posted below. Until next time, remember, this is the place to receive your regular, dynamic dosage.